Hi, everyone. The Stanley Cup playoffs continue tonight, but the games are overshadowed by the passing of a legend, our dear friend and colleague, Bob Cole. Bob Cole, simply the best at what he did. He brought an unrivaled passion and love for the game. That voice, those words, that incredible feeling he left us with at the end of every game. You knew something big was going to happen when Bob Cole was on the mic, because that crescendo in his voice allowed us to know something special was in the air. An entire nation hanging on his every word. Bob Cole, an icon, and hockey fans say thank you.
You feel so privileged to listen to him.
Hello, everybody. This is Bob Cole in the broadcast booth.
You always knew it was a big game when Bob Cole was calling your game.
He's got the unique voice.
He's the Sinatra of broadcasting.
Without question, the nicest man in hockey. He's the Gordie Howe of commentating.
Here's Lemieux, the center penalty coming.
The passion that he has for the game, that talent of being able to set the table, he's got a real knack for that.
There's all these great plays, but they're almost enhanced by a great call.
It is Gilmore waiting around the net, waiting, he's open! Gilmore! And he's won it!
Every game he made exciting. That's what makes him such a tremendous broadcaster.
Nobody has done it faster.
He always sets the scene and seems to know that the big moment is coming.
Shortside, there is again. Scores! Desjardins! And the series is a brand new one.
I had to hang on to him so he didn't jump out of his seat occasionally.
Was able to paint a portrait of the game.
On a hot June night in New York, the Rangers are Stanley Cup champions!
One game I remember, Matt Sundin scored a hat trick, and he scored the overtime winner for his 500th goal.
Sundin is up there. Two goals on the night. Well scored! Matt Sundin wins the game with 500 in this terrific career. The captain of the Maple Leafs has this crowd going.
The couple great memories I have was the first one when we won the first Stanley Cup. Bob Cole said, there's a new bunch on the block.
There's a new bunch on the block in the National Hockey League. The Oilers have won the Stanley Cup.
And then the gold medal game in Salt Lake City.
It is Joe Sakic scores! Joe Sakic scores! Surely that's gotta be it!
It sounded great, and it sounds better every time you listen to it.
They're going home! Yeah, they're going home!
Oh, my goodness! Scores! Goal! Korea! Can you believe it? Scores! Marshawn! And the place goes crazy!
He's authentic, he's Canadian, he's entertaining, and he's ours.
Everything is happening. Could you ask for anything more? Oh, baby! Oh, baby, for sure!
Another one down. Good night, everybody.
The great Bob Cole, a life well led. Kelly Rudy, Elliot Friedman, friends, colleagues, yep. Some great moments to share.
Okay, so personally for me, it's the Easter epic, right? Game 7, Saturday night, Bob and Harry. It can't get better than that, right? I make 73 saves, so it's a memorable night. And then my favorite moment, I watched it that summer. My mom and dad recorded the game. I went back home to Edmonton to watch it and just to hear this call.
Comes to the line. LaFontaine shot. He scores! LaFontaine at the blue line here in the fourth overtime.
Wow.
Yeah. So many iconic moments, hey? Like, he's attached. He created a lot of these iconic moments.
I have to say, I wasn't that emotional all day until the last notes of that open.
Yes.
Just because all the quotes and 1933 to 2024 comes up, seeing your reaction, seeing the way you did that. You know, he's the soundtrack of my life in a lot of ways. And also, when I was hired in Hockey Night in Canada and got to work with him, they were some of the greatest days of my life. But a couple things you kind of heard there in the open, but need to be heard a little bit more. The smile on Joe Sakic's face in that interview, I think for a whole country, that gold medal in 2002.
Yeah, that was a moment that resonates with me as well, right? 50 years, and we all were, after what happened in Nagano, we were waiting, and he held us in great suspense, the great call. That call, Elliot, that call there on Sakic, clinching it.
Another personal story. Spring of 2009, Greg Millen and myself get a chance to play a round of golf during the playoffs with Bob Cole. So all day long, I am missing my putts right. And we have a little bit of money on the round, right? Mm-hmm. Bob's not saying anything. Greg's not saying anything. So finally, the match is over on the 18th hole. I have a meaningless, about a 10-footer. So Bob comes, hey, wait a minute, you know, with that voice, about, don't play, don't putt yet. Then he lines me up properly, and he goes, now just hit it firm. That should go right in. So I do that, goes right in, and then I pretend I'm mad at Bob. I go, you've known the whole round. You knew. Just a little bit of alignment. I'm swearing at him, pretending. Of course, I'm teasing and pretending to be mad. He laughed and laughed and laughed that he knew all along what I was doing wrong. I loved it.
That's outstanding, Kelly. Just finally for me, like my first memory, I really thought about it today. My first memory watching hockey, I was 5 years old, early 1976. There was a couple of seconds of it in the open, and it was Soviet Red Army and the Philadelphia Flyers.
Oh, yeah.
They are leaving the ice.
They're gonna go.
The Soviets are leaving. They're going home. They're going home. Yeah, they're going home. In 72, in Moscow, we stayed, and we took it all. And in 74, and now, the Philadelphia Flyers roam around a little bit, and they're going home.
You know, the thing you talked about later, Dave, was that he never really editorialized a lot. He was a caller. He described the play. He never really editorialized a lot, but he felt in that moment he couldn't help himself but say how he felt.
So many iconic moments, and it stretched out for many, many decades, and the players' reverence towards him. You walked into a dressing room with Bob Cole, and the players didn't want to usher you out like they usually do with the media. They were embracing it. Beautiful. Listen, we miss you, Bob. Yeah. We love you, Bob. Thank you, Bob.